I'll get it started, and I think you'll see the idea.
Okay, good. Good plan.
Okay, and of course, nobody has any requests, right? So I should just dig in my notes and see a good one. Let me see. Like that one, we did that one last week. Read the problem. So, most of us are familiar with the effects of a mild electric shock. The effects of a severe shock can be devastating and often fatal. This is a little bit of a sick problem, but I like it. Shock results when current is passed through the body, and especially the heart. Okay, so it's current that causes shock, not voltage. All right? A person can be modeled as a network of resistances. So this is a person. You recognize that? Consider the model circuit shown. These are all models, right? Are they accurate or not? Well, not sure. The heart's represented by RB. No, that must be RA. No, there's a typo there. RH. This is the heart. The floor has a resistance to current flow equal to RF, and the person is standing barefoot on the floor. The upper body resistance is 20. And the lower body resistance is 30.
They get these numbers.
Determine the voltage developed across the heart and the current flowing through the heart of the person when he or she firmly grasps one end of a voltage source whose other end is connected to the floor. This type of accident might occur in a swimming pool or a boat dock. All right, so. So this is basically the given model for the person, and what we want to do is find the voltage developed across the heart. So I'll call that VH, and the current flowing through the heart. Call it IH. Okay, so notice I was very careful to label on the drawing the things that I'm, you know, identifying here that I'm saying I want to find. All right, this is actually pretty straightforward. So we're gonna have to, well, I mean, there's a lot of ways we can do it. I would probably find the equivalent resistance. Here's what my idea is. Tell me if you've got a better idea. I'll find the equivalent resistance to all these resistors and then find the current going into that branch. And then I'll put the equivalent resistance back to these individual resistors and use, I'll use current division, but of course the resistance in this branch will be 130.
But you don't want to do have that 130, right? Because you're going to eventually have to split it up again.
Right? Well, that will help, that will give me the current, but then the voltage, of course, once I have the current, I can use Ohm's law.
Okay, cool.
So, all right, so let's do that. So these two are in series, so that's 130. 130 in parallel with 500 would be, let's see, 1 over, well, there's only two of them, so 500 times 130 divided by 630, right? That's going to be the combination of these three. Everybody agree? And then we just add 220.
So right now the objective here is to find the current I, H, current
No. I'm trying to find this current here. I'll call it IA. No, I'll call it IW. So the equivalent resistance that's coming off this 50 volt source, you know, that's being connected to this 50 volt source is this mess here. Because I combined these two and got 130. Then these two in parallel, I got that thing that I don't know what the answer is, but it's 500 times 130 over 630, right? Because for two resistors in parallel, you just take the product divided by the sum. And then, so then I have that, this equivalent resistor to this here, and then I see that the rest is all in series, so I just add it, you know, 20 plus 200 plus whatever that thing is, so I'm just adding 220 to it. So, whatever that number is, that's the equivalent resistance. Now I can find IA because it's just Ohm's law. You know, the voltage across this equivalent resistance is positive 50, negative, like that. So the current is going into the positive terminal. Ohm's law says V equals IR, so I equals V over R, so 50 over, can anybody do this?
322.
Thank you. And then, so what's 50 divided by 323?
0.155136.
Good enough. Okay, so now we go back. Oops. I'm sorry. I called it IW here, and then I called it IA here. Not good. Anybody notice that and not say it?
Yeah, I was wondering.
Next time, say something. Yeah. Because otherwise, I look like a fool. You don't want me to look like a fool. Okay, so I labeled it IW here, so I better label the same current by the same symbol. Thank you. Okay, so now we know IW, now we can go back here and use current division. And again, it's not exactly the pretty picture that we have in our mind for current division, but it's close enough. You know, we gotta be able to be flexible and, you know, interpret this. So we do have a resistor with another resistor in parallel, but the other resistor is 130, not 100. Everybody see that? Okay, so we can just write down IH, its current division. It's going to be a fraction of the total. The total is IW, which we just found here. And the fraction is going to be the conductance, which is 1 over 130, divided by the sum of all the conductances. So 1 over 500 plus 1 over 130. And that number .123. when you plug in the value that you got here and do this, you get .123 amps. Yes.
So we found IW. I'm with you there. And then can you show a diagram showing how you
got IH? Yes.
Yeah.
So I've got IW coming into the 500 ohm, and then it's being split into the 100 and the 30. And I'm going to just redraw it a little bit different than what we have there, but I haven't really changed the relationships. So, you know, you can stretch wires and compress wires and change the direction as long as you don't change the essential relationships between the elements. In other words, don't change what's in parallel or what's in series. So you all agree that just me kind of stretching this wire and turning it around the corner gives me that picture right there. And it's more obvious in that picture that we've got these two branches in parallel, where the resistance of this branch is 50, the resistance of this branch is, no, this is 500. Yeah, 500, and then this one is 130. So now, okay, so there's the IW. This is IH, right? IH.
Yeah.
And so now I'm just using current division, because current division says you've got some current that's being divided amongst resistors in parallel. It's going to be a fraction of the total. So I always say that in my head. I mean, it's like, okay, it's a fraction of the total. So I'm showing a fraction, although I'm not showing the numerator and the denominator yet, but I know it's going to be some fraction of the total. And then now I have to worry, okay, well, what's the fraction? Well, is it the resistance of this branch divided by the sum of all the resistances of all the branches, or the conductance? And you just got to memorize. For current division, it's conductance. For voltage division, it's resistance. So however you can remember that. So that means it's 1 over 130, and then divided by the sum of all the conductances, so 1 over 500 plus 1 over 130. And so that's exactly what I mean.
So why would you do that? Isn't 500, that resistor 500 ohms not involved in finding IR or IH?
It is involved. It will matter. If that's a different value, you'll have a different value for IH.
Or, but like, shouldn't that not even be in the equation?
I'm not particularly interested in this current, but if I was, I'll call it IK, I could find it also by current division. But I'm just, it just wasn't, nobody asked me about it, so I just didn't even bother to calculate it. What is IW relative to our IH?
No, I mean, like, if I find it is not involved with this range, IW.
It is involved.
Oh.
I'm not the one that said it's not involved.
Okay.
Julian
okay.
said it wasn't
yeah,
involved. I think it is involved.
Yeah, it is.
So
I was telling him, like, otherwise, EW would be equal to IH.
That's right,
yeah.
Right. Right, exactly.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay.
So if this, in what condition, well, under what circumstances would IW be equal to IH if this were an open circuit or an infinite resistance? If this were zero, then it would be a short circuit, and IH would actually be zero. So you can kind of play around with those extremes. All right. Okay, good. We've got time for me to do the problem I wanted to do.
Oh, we never found DH.
Oh, but that's almost trivial.
So we just use...
Because we have IH,
yeah.
We have RH. Eh, I'm not going to bother.
I'm going to give our time.
I mean, it's not trivial, but...
It's multiplying.
You can finish it.